Hi guys! Okay, so this video is another video inspired by questions that my patients with high hamstring tendinopathy ask me. This one's about ice and whether if you use ice for your pain, are you inhibiting your healing and your training effect? So my name is Maryke. I'm one of the physiotherapists from sportsinjuryphysio.com where you can get online physiotherapy assessment as well as treatment for your injuries. Have a look at the description if you want a link to our website. Okay, so ice, what's the deal with it? So if you've got high hamstring tendinopathy, you know that it can be really, really painful. And for quite, I would say probably 80, 85% of my patients with that condition tend to find if they sit on ice or use ice when the pain's really bad, that it can decrease the pain significantly and it can make them so much more comfortable during the day. But then there's loads of people shouting out on the internet that ice is bad for you. You shouldn't be using it for injuries because it prevents inflammation. Inflammation is needed for healing. Same thing for training. After training, don't use ice. The problem is that they are taking research that was done in a very specific way to prove other things, and they're applying it directly to sports injuries. Now, there is no research out there to show if you're going to use ice for your pain from your high hamstring injury, that it's going to inhibit your healing and it's going to inhibit your progress. That research does not exist at this moment in time. The research that's out there is usually done on cyclists and other high-level athletes where they look at training programs over time, where they do full-body immersion into ice baths shortly after they've trained. And they look at how that affects their training and stuff. Now, interestingly enough, there's equal number of research studies that shows that it can have, the training effect is not that great if you keep on regularly icing it. And there's other studies that shows that it doesn't have that much of effect. And with regards to inflammation, that actually it doesn't decrease the inflammatory response any more than doing an active recovery, which is like gentle cycling, which cyclists do both. So there's not strong research for that. You've also got to remember that those studies doesn't show that there's no training adaptation. It just shows that this one doesn't adapt quite as well as this one. And it's not that big a difference usually. So what does this mean for somebody with high hamstring tendinopathy? You've got to take it into context. In high hamstring tendinopathy, pain can really ruin your progress, much more than a bit of ice can, because pain stops you from moving. Pain stops you from going for walks. Pain stops you from sitting down. Pain can stop you from doing your exercises. So if ice is effective at bringing your pain levels down so that you can do your exercises, so that you can move a bit more, so that you can sleep at night or sit a bit more, then ice is a brilliant thing to use. It will not reduce your training capacity or your training adaptations to the point where you're not going to see healing. Also, remember, when you use ice for your high hamstring tendinopathy, you don't go and sit in an ice bath. You actually just have ice on that painful spot. So your muscles are still free. They're not being affected by it at all. And yes, fine. Often it can be applied directly after you've done your exercise. But quite often people just use it after you've been in the car for a while. So you've not done any training. There's nothing to inhibit. No healing process to inhibit by using ice at that point. So honestly, I want to put your mind at ease that use ice if you need it to decrease your pain, because pain is the limiting thing with high hamstring tendinopathies, and we need to try and limit the pain as much as possible, that you can move, that you can do your strength training, and that you can just have a more comfortable life day to day. So have a look. I've also done a video about whether sitting through pain and things is useful. So have a look at that video as well, because I feel these two go well together. But if you've got any questions or you want more help with an injury, you're welcome to message me through my website. The link to the website is in the description of this video. Take care.